Chinnadurai is the Senior Vice President of Animal Health and Welfare for the Chicago Zoological Society. He is joining us there. You see him live to talk a little bit more about this. Nice to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, well, let's start with a little background, and you tell us about the threat level right now, what you're seeing as opposed to perhaps what you've seen in the past.
Sure. We're very concerned because this year's strain is what's called a high pathogenicity avian influenza, which means it's very easily transmitted from wild birds to domestic birds, and it can cause a lot of disease in especially in domestic poultry, but in a lot of species that are very closely related to chickens and turkeys. So we have guinea fowl and peacocks and other wild bird, other non-domestic birds that could contract the disease.
So this is, I know, going to be a disappointment for a lot of people who are looking forward to visiting the various exhibits. How long do you think this problem is going to remain in place that requires you to take these kinds of protective measures?
It could potentially be another few months. The disease moves along the timeline of migratory bird migration. So this could potentially last this month into next month before we start to see a downturn in the number of cases.
And talk about what some of the zoos in the area, not just here in the Chicago area, but across really the Midwest, what they're doing. Because I know one option is obviously bringing the birds inside or bringing the animals inside, but what other precautions and measures are you taking?
So we've been in continuous contact with the regulatory agencies, both at the state and the national level, to get the best guidance on best practices for keeping our animals safe. The susceptible species, the very susceptible species, we are bringing those animals indoors to keep them isolated from wild birds. And then we're also taking additional biosecurity precautions, things like foot baths and disinfection stations, so we can make sure we're not tracking in anything from a wild bird into an indoor building.
And so far, there have been no outbreaks, I believe, at least not here in the U.S., at any of our local zoos.
That's correct. So far in this outbreak, we've not seen any cases in zoo birds, thankfully.
Okay. Can you talk about how this brings us to like the bigger picture here when we're talking about the nation's poultry supply here? How long will this be an issue, and what kinds of measures are being taken nationwide, and the impact that we're seeing on prices when inflation is already out of control?
Sure, that's a great question. The departments of agriculture at the state levels are very much on top of this, trying to make sure that any cases that come from wild birds into domestic birds are caught, and then those areas are isolated as quickly as possible. So the hope is that biosecurity precautions, all of the years of preparation that the departments of agriculture have put in to prevent widespread outbreaks, that they're hopefully going to build on that experience and limit the spread of this disease to more turkeys and poultry than is necessary. There will obviously be some impact on egg production, on chicken and turkey production, but hopefully it will be limited by those precautions.
Just real quick, and I'm sure this is probably a really simple question, but is there anything the general public can do, somebody who may be watching at home, to make sure that this doesn't spread?
For those who have poultry at home, backyard poultry, chickens and turkeys, trying to keep them isolated from wild birds is going to be really important. You want to minimize the contact between wild waterfowl and your domestic birds to keep those birds safe.
Okay, Dr. Sathya Chinnadurai, we appreciate your time today. I'm sure we'll talk to you again soon. Thank you, sir.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you.
All right, up next here, the U.S. Postal Service pays tribute to beloved children's author Shel Silverstein at his childhood school here in Chicago.
And the weekend is the top contender at the upcoming Billboard Music Awards.